Hello children, I welcome you all to English class of class 6. Today we are going to know about our unit 2. In our unit 2 we have three readings: Telangana the Pride of People, reading B In the Bazaars of Hyderabad, it's a poem, and reading C Bammere Potana, the Jewel of Telugu Literature. Reading A Telangana the Pride of People. This lesson happens like a discussion of son Kiran with his family members. He had many questions for his father, being emotional while reading the newspaper. Then father tries to explain him about the Telangana people who actually continuously fought for making their dream come true. And on that day, the state of Telangana was declared as 29th state of the country. Later, Mother Lakshmi and Sister Indu join the discussion. People of Telangana celebrate many festivals, national as well as regional. Some of the regional festivals are Bonalu, Batukamma and Peetla Panduga. Bonalu festival is celebrated during Ashadam and it's according to lunar calendar. It's a festival celebrated as a thanksgiving to Goddess Mahankali for fulfilling the good wishes. The women folk only pray for the good health of the people. Batukamma festival is celebrated as a part of Dasara. The festival has historical and religious importance. Here the women folk arrange different kinds of flowers and pray Mother Goddess Gauramma. Muharram festival, also known as Peetla Panduga, is celebrated in many parts of our Telangana state. It's the symbol of religious tolerance of our people. The saris of Pochampalli, Gadwal and Narayanpet of Telangana state are very popular for their attractive patterns. Weavers of Sirisilla produce saris that fit in a matchbox. And of course, the wooden toys of Nirmal steal the hearts of everyone. Besides the celebration of festivals, Telangana is also known for celebration of jataras. The Sammakka and Saralamma Jatara of Medaram in Warangal is one of the biggest gathering in the world. There are several places of tourist attraction as well as places of worship in Telangana. Let's know about them. Charminar. Charminar was constructed by Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah in the year 1591 to commemorate the end of plague in the city. Of course, Charminar is a symbol of Hyderabad. Golconda Fort. Golconda Fort was initially constructed by Kakatiya dynasty in 13th century. However, it rose to prominence under the rule of Qutub Shahis. Nagarjun Sagar Dam. Nagarjun Sagar Dam is located in Nalgonda district. It is constructed across the river Krishna. It provides irrigational water to the districts of both Telugu-speaking states. Yadadri or Yadagiri Gutta. This temple is the seat of Lord Lakshmi Narasimha Swami and it's located in Yadadri Bhuvanagiri district, 62 kilometers away from Hyderabad. Vemulavada Shiva Temple. This temple is the seat of Lord Rajarajeshwara Swami and this is located in Rajanna Sirisilla district. Alampur Jogulamba Temple. Alampur is a place famous for meeting point of two sacred rivers, Tungabhadra and Krishna. Here, Goddess Shakti is worshipped in the name of Jogulamba. Of course, it's the fifth Shaktipeet of Ashtadasa Shaktipeetas. Bhadrachalam Temple. This is the seat of Lord Rama and this temple is constructed on the banks of River Godavari. This is in the district of Bhadrachalam Kottagudem. Sri Ranganayaka Swami Temple. This is located in the Vanaparthi district of Telangana. This is the seat of Ranganayaka Swami. Salajing Museum is one of the three national museums which has the antiques and portraits collected by a single person, Salajing. There are many great people with great literary knowledge from the state of Telangana. Bammere Potana, whose Bhagavatam, known as Potana Bhagavatam or Andhra Maha Bhagavatam, is translated from Vyasa's Bhagavatam in Sanskrit. Kancharla Gopanna, also known as Bhaktaramadasu, he made Telugu literature so great and remembered by everyone with his kirtanas. So Malliganti Suri, Kalaji Narayan Rao, Dasaradi Rangacharyulu and Dasaradi Krishnamacharyulu of the recent times also must be surely remembered and respected as the jewels of Telangana literature. Oggu Katha, it's a famous and very popular folklore singing. It narrates the stories of Mallanna, Beerappa and Yellamma. Perini Shivatandavam, this is the state dance of Telangana. It was originally performed by the soldiers of Kakatiya dynasty. Like before they go for a warfare, they used to do this dance and do the invocation of Lord Shiva, and they dedicated this dance to Lord Shiva. In recent times, this dance was actually revived by Sri Nataraja Ramakrishna. So children, isn't it exciting to know about Telangana? So all the temples, tourist places, antiques, art forms, literature, whatnot, children, language, everything of them will contribute to the culture and heritage of state of Telangana. Reading B. In the Bazaars of Hyderabad, poem by Sarojini Naidu. Sarojini Naidu is also known as Nightingale of India or Bharatiya Kokila. She is also an important person and played a vital role in Indian freedom struggle. She is also famous for her writing style, and this poem is one of her beautiful collection. In this poem, she clearly narrates and makes us feel like how the markets of Hyderabad, how the bazaars of Hyderabad existed. We can see the merchants describing the wares like whatever they sold. They had a collection of crimson, that is red colored and silver colored turbans, and they even had tunics of purple brocade and amber paneled mirrors and jade handled daggers. The vendors here were selling saffron, lentil and rice. The maidens were selling the powders of sandalwood, henna and spice. The peddlers were selling chessmen and ivory dice, and the goldsmiths were really superb at their work, like they were making wristlets, anklets and rings, and of course bells for the feet of blue pigeons. They even made gold girdles, the ornaments for the dancers, and gold scabbards, gold sheets or covers for the king's swords. The fruitmen were selling fruits, citron, pomegranate and plum. Meanwhile, there were magicians playing all spells. The flowers were actually selling flowers, and also they were weaving bright and red colored tassels. And the new garnet chaplets were also available, and they were to provide perfume to the dead. So you can understand, children, this poem entirely gives us a clear view like how the bazaars of Hyderabad were busy with people running around and people buying and selling different things. We are really very happy that we had such a nice poem by Sarojini Naidu to give us a view of how the bazaars existed. Read this poem and understand the essence of it. Bammira Potana, the jewel of Telugu literature, is our reading scene. Bammira Potana was an amazing poet, children. He was born in Bammira village of Warangal district in Telangana. His father was Kesanna and mother was Lakshmamma. He belonged to an agricultural family. He translated Vyasa's Bhagavatam from Sanskrit into Telugu. It is also called as Potana's Bhagavatam or Andhra Maha Bhagavatam. He wrote Bogini Dandakam for King Sri Singhabhupala and Veerabhadra Vijayam. Veerabhadra Vijayam was describing the adventures of Veerabhadra, the son of Lord Shiva. Potana was initially the devotee of Lord Shiva. Later he became the devotee of Lord Rama, and he developed interest in salvation. And he also describes us like Lord Rama, in his dream, himself complimented, gave him the appreciation for the work that Potana has done. Potana dedicated his Bhagavatam to Lord Rama and he refused the orders of King Padmanayaka, as the King Padmanayaka asked him to dedicate his work Bhagavatam to himself. He said no and he would dedicate it only to Lord Rama. Potana was fond of rhythm and repetition of sounds. So it is the rhythm and repetition only, children, that gives the beauty to the poem. And his descriptions touch hearts of readers, whether be it talented people who are reading or whether be it even the illiterate people who just listen and grab the sounds and enjoy the beauty of the poems or the narration. All of them simply enjoyed the Potana's narrations and poems. And even the common people, they used to quote, repeat the verses of Gajendra Moksham and Prahlada Charitra from Potana's Bhagavatam. Potana's work live forever and ever in the hearts of all Telugu speaking people and whoever has this point of enjoying literature of Telugu. Children, let's know about vocabulary and grammar given in this unit. Under vocabulary, we have opinion adjectives. Adjectives are describing words. Adjectives always tell us more about people or things. So here we have opinion adjectives. By the name itself, we can understand the adjectives are giving out some opinion. So they tell us about age, size or color, or help us in making some opinion or some judgment we can make out by actually using them. So here we have some examples like nice, beautiful, friendly, good, great, bad, terrible, comfortable, excellent, uncomfortable, awful, funny, boring. So you can understand by these words we can tell our opinion. Children, try to solve the exercises given in your textbook and know more about opinion adjectives usage. In grammar, we have linking words. Linking words, by the name itself, suggest us that they are linking two ideas. So it's easy for us to join two ideas together by using these words. Linking words are always used to provide connectivity in the flow of speech. Here, we can understand that usage of these words is enabling us to maintain some kind of easiness in expressing our thoughts. For example, a girl knows to sing, a girl knows to paint. She can say, she knows to sing as well as paint. For suppose you are given an ice cream and also a chocolate, you can say, I not only want ice cream but also want the chocolate. So you are expressing your point of view that you want both of them. So here we can even solve some examples given in our textbook. She sings Telugu songs, she sings Hindi songs, and we are supposed to join them using the conjunction or the linking word and. We can say she sings Telugu and Hindi songs. She works on computer, she designs programs. We have to join them using not only but also. It is very comfortable to say, she not only works on computer, but also designs programs. Children, try solving the examples and exercises given in textbook and enjoy using linking words. Let's know about the discourses or creative writing given in this lesson. Under major discourse, we are knowing about how to write an essay. When we are writing an essay, we must take care that the information is properly arranged and the information must be relevant. The essay always gives out the opinion of the writer. The writer must arrange the information like it should have an introduction, it should have some supporting statements, and he can even give some conclusion. In this lesson, we learn to how to write an essay giving importance of any monument or tourist place that is visited from the state of Telangana? The next question is writing conversation. Conversation is always the dialogue exchanged between two speakers. It is totally different from essay. Understand, children? When two speakers are speaking to each other, they exchange some point of view, some argument, or some opinion between them. They talk and discuss. So the conversation should exactly written in that form. And here in this lesson, we try to write a conversation of you and your friend discussing about any place of cultural importance in your district. Under minor discourse, we try and learn writing an invitation. We have already practiced writing invitation. Of course, writing invitation is so exciting. The invitation must always have the important details like the venue and what is the program about that they are invited. And venue, timing, the place that they need to reach and all the details like invitee details and inviter details. Everything must be neatly included, clearly expressed. And we have already practiced writing birthday invitations. Children, practice them again. Thank you all for listening to the class. Meet you in the next class.